Most bikes these days have air suspension, forks and rear shocks if they're full suspension. And the great thing about those is they're really easily adjusted and also very tweakable. So we often talk about bottomless tokens. So in this video, with the help of GMBN Tech, we'll let you know what they are, how they work, how to fit them, and then I'll give you some demonstrations out on the trail of how they affect the suspension and how it feels on the trail. I've often heard pro racers say that they add more volume spacers to their suspension, and I sometimes wonder if it's just that macho thing to say, I ride my bike so hard that I need my suspension to ramp up loads. Or does it make the bike too harsh and you're not using the suspension as it should? So I think let's start today with a bit of a drop-off test to see how tokens can affect my fork and how far in it goes. So today I'm riding my Canyon Strive. I've got a 170mm RockShox Lyric up front. They come standard with one volume spacer in there. I've actually got two in there because I'm well hard. So I'm sending it off that drop. It is quite a harsh landing and we'll see by the magic of camera how much travel I use. Rubber ring is showing exactly that much. So now I'll swap out for four tokens and see how it compares. What I'm gonna try and do is land exactly the same for the drop. Not an exact science to this, but might be interesting. Right, back up to the same pressure, 65 PSI, because I think that's the idea. If you start just making your fork harder rather than putting volume spacers in, you lose that small bump sensitivity, I believe. Is that right, Doddy?
Thanks, Neil. Right, let's talk air volume spacers, these little plastic things here. Now, firstly, why would you want to put these in a fork? Quite simply, with an air suspension fork, you can tune the way the air spring feels. When you compress air, it essentially gets more progressive through the travel naturally, and you can make it more progressive by adding in air volume spacers. Now, depending on what model of fork you have, there will be a maximum amount of these you can fit, and they're very specific to each fork. For example, these are for Fox 36, this one is for Fox 34, and these ones are for RockShox Lyric. They're all slightly different out there, so you need to make sure you have the correct ones for your fork. And it tailors basically the way the fork feels. With none in there, you get a slightly more linear feel. That's the sort of ride that Henry likes. He likes to use all his travel all the time, whereas Blake puts the maximum amount of volume spaces in his fork because he wants it to feel really, really firm towards the end of the travel. So if you're a sort of rider that likes doing big jumps and hucking off stuff to flat, then you're going to want some air volume spaces inside your forks. Now the great thing is, they don't cost a lot of money. It's really cool because you can customize the way your fork feels and they're dead easy to fit. Now all you need to fit them, obviously, is the correct volume spaces for your forks. You need a shock pump and you need a socket. But the socket is the most important thing. This one is actually a branded Fox socket, but you don't need one of those. As long as the socket is the correct size and it's got a flat edge on it. You do not want one that's got a chamfered edge because you can round off the aluminium bolt on the top of the fork there. You've got to make sure it's got a really good fit. That is absolutely crucial. Nice and easy to fit. Remove the top cap, deflate the air from the fork itself and simply remove that top cap and you will see where they sit in place. The RockShox bottomless tokens actually screw together directly into the top cap, whereas the Fox ones clip together. Nice and simple. Take your time, make sure you don't cross thread when you're actually putting the top back in, and do it up nice and tight. Don't over tighten, it doesn't need to be crazy tight, but remember that is the air leg, so you don't want to have it loose and any air escaping.
Yeah, definitely used less travel on that and it didn't feel harsh. So I could see why more volume spacers would be good for doing bigger, gnarlier stuff. Let's go down to zero spacers, try it again before we go out to the trail. There you go, proof's in the pudding. I used more travel, not significantly more. But the fork also felt really similar. It's just on the big hit, I've used more travel, less spacers, less travel with more spacers, so it makes total sense. It just then, when I did land at the very end of it, I did feel like weight started to go forward, so that's where it feels to me. adding a bit more volume spaces. When you go on those big hits and you don't want all your weight to start going forward, you probably do want your fork to stay a bit higher in its travel. That might be a case of when you need or want more volume spaces. Okay, to the trail, I'm gonna do three different runs. I'm back to my stock setup now with two tokens in there. Have a run, see how it feels. I've been sessioning this trail all morning, so know it really well, know the conditions. Then I'm gonna put four volume spaces in and then try another run with nothing in there and see if harsh or comfort or somewhere in the middle is best for me. Right, catch you in a bit. Okay, right, I'm gonna ride down this trail over here. It's fairly short, some nice fast berms at the top that you can press into quite hard. There's some fast rooty sections where you want a comfortable bike, and then some steeper, rough stuff at the end where you're going to want the bike to stay fairly high in its travel, but soak those up. So I'm going to time these on my Garmin as well, just to have some comparison between feel and time. Right, first run on what is my stock setup. Let's see how it feels. And that one. Whoa. Super muddy at the moment, and some jumps. That little bit there, some big old braking bumps. Fork felt quite good. Right over the roots. Bomb section, rough down here. Braking hard as well. So the weight goes really far forward there. I want it to stay up. I want the bike to stay slack. Pretty slippery through there. Felt like I'm not quite bombed out, but definitely quite a hard hit on the fork. I'll mess that up. There you go. So, first run on my base settings, two volume spaces. You can see that there's not much left there. I've almost bottomed out, so now I'll go up to the four. I'm thinking that on zero volume spaces, there's a good chance I'm gonna bottom that out. Okay, run two. Now with four volume spaces, but I forgot to put my glasses on. Try again. Run two, four tokens, maximum volume spaces. Right, this will be a test. Oh, I like that actually. Does feel like it's higher in its travel there. I felt like I could sort of get around those corners quicker. Good, it's maintaining the geometry of my bike a little bit better. That was good as well. Landed right in the middle of the braking bumps that time, and it felt quite good. You know what? So far, so good. Wow, that felt good. That also felt good. Steeper and rougher. I can just stay behind the bike. Not diving in so much. And the question is how much would it tire you out on a longer track? Because this is only short. Definitely used less travel with four spaces, which leaves me with, I don't know, what's that, 25 mil of travel left. Feels pretty good. There's no really big hits on that track, so you know, maybe that is worth saving for those gnarlier tracks, bigger, rougher, harder hits. So that felt actually really good, and the clock says it was 2 seconds faster. Right, now to zero spaces in the fork. Is it going to be more comfortable? Is it going to be slower? Let's find out. Onto the roots. Felt good. Down the really rough stuff. Does feel like I'm a bit further forward on the bike through there then, which isn't the most comfortable. Oh, I'm there. It's got a big G out. I don't like the weight. It's going really far forward. Last time I showed the fork, that is with zero spacers, so you can see I've used almost all my travel. Don't think I bottomed out, to be fair, but 2 or 3 mil left. So I think after those runs, actually got exactly the same time, so same as my fastest run, surprisingly enough. So time's done out, it's hard to tell. It's been a long day. I reckon I've done 8 runs on that track, so feeling pretty tired, but still put a good run in. But I think for me it's the actual feel. I like the geometry of the bike to stay the same. Trying to put more spaces back in. Oh, here he is, Jack. You've had a good time in the cafe whilst I've been doing all the work. Right, I think after all that, I've decided to go for 3. So put one more than normal into my 4 because I really liked actually running it on 4. So I thought I'd compromise. So easy to do, I'm gonna try 3. I'm also thinking I might drop the pressure slightly. So down to something like 62 PSI from 65. So hopefully keep some of that small bump sensitivity, but ramp up a bit more at the end. Doddy, what do you think?
Okay, Neil, yeah, that's quite a good point, actually. So there's 2 ways of doing this. You could either remain with the same air pressure in your fork, and then by adding volume spaces, it just means you're never really gonna use that end of the stroke. That's kind of good, like save it for do it or die sort of moments where you're jumping off something big and you need it in reserve. But you could also take advantage of having a fork that naturally ramps up like that and being a bit more supportive and release some pressure, maybe like 5 PSI, even 10 PSI out of the fork. And you'll find it's gonna be a lot more supple initially, but it will still hold itself up enough and you won't be going through all of the travel all of the time like you would with less volume spaces.
Okay, well, I think I've decided that I'll just try it. I can always go up a bit more pressure, always take the volume spacer out again if I wanted to. I guess that's a good thing about it. It's a bit like I would never run the same tyres all year round. You can always change your suspension and play around with it dead easily. So quite happy with what I've done today. Don't forget to check out GMBN Tech, completely separate YouTube channel. Loads of helpful things over there. Doddy and Henry doing loads of great stuff. And don't forget to follow us on social media, Instagram, of course. Right,